Welcome back, Tigers. If you find yourself creating formula fields to show certain data in a report in Salesforce, then this video is for you. We're going to review how to use one of my favorite features, how to show related record fields using a custom report type. Our use case is we need to send a closed one opportunity report to our finance team. This report needs to include all of the closed one opportunities by sales rep, and it also needs to include the sales rep's employee ID number, as well as their manager's role name, name, and employee number as well. Now, if we look at this standard report type and we go to edit, we can check out the fields that we have available on the owner, and we can see that we don't have any custom fields that we've created on the user object. If we go back into setup, and we go to our user object, we have an employee number right here that we need to include in our report. In order to do this, we'll need to create a custom report type. We'll go to Home, Report Types, and we're going to click New Custom Report Type. Our primary object is going to be Opportunity, and this is going to be called Opportunities with Related Record Fields. And we're going to use this report to pull information from the records related to the opportunity, like owner and manager information. We're going to store this in our opportunities folder, and we're going to mark it as deployed so we can use it right away. And then we only have one object in this report, so we'll click save. And then we'll come down here and we'll go to edit layout. We're going to add two sections. The first section we're going to add is opportunity owner information. The second section that we're going to add is opportunity owner's manager information. And we're going to add the fields we need right here underneath the link called Add Fields Related via Lookup. So this is going to allow us to get to all of the objects that are related to the opportunity. Now we're going to go to Opportunity Owner, and then these are all the fields on the Opportunity Owner's user record. So we're going to choose Employee Number, and we're going to choose the manager name right there. We'll click OK, and it dropped the two fields right up here in this section. So we're just going to move them down into the Opportunity Owner section. Then we're going to go back and we're going to click Add Fields Related via Lookup again, and we're going to go to the Opportunity Owner, and then we're going to click View Related Fields under the manager. Now, each of our user records has the manager field populated with the manager's information. It's a standard field that's a lookup to the user object. Now you can see when I click View Related Fields, it looks like nothing happened, but it actually added another breadcrumb here at the top. And so I'm going to do that again because you can keep going. You may inadvertently add too many manager lookups because it looks like nothing happened when you click that. So if we click Add Fields and then Opportunity Owner, and then if we don't see the manager here, then you're not adding fields for the manager yet. So once we click View Related Fields, now these are the fields from the manager's user record. So we will click Employee Number from here, and then we're going to do the role. Drop those fields up here. So I will drag those down here, and then we're going to click Save. Then we're going to go and create a new report, and we're going to look for our new report type. And it's right here, Opportunities Related Record Fields. We'll click Start Report, and then we'll add all our fields. Now we can see when we type in owner, we can see employee name, and we can see the manager's name. So we'll go ahead and click on those. Those are the fields that we added to the report type. And then we can see we also have the manager field. So we have manager employee number and manager role name. We'll click save and run. And now we have a report that is by our opportunity owner, and we have our employee number here. We have our manager's full name, our manager's employee number, and then our manager's role name. And that's it. That's how you use this super fantastic feature to make your life easier and you don't have to create formula fields anymore. If you found this video helpful, be sure to give it a like. And be sure to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on future hot tips that will make your life easier in Salesforce. Take care, and I'll see you next time. Bye.